हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू आवर यूट्यूब चैनल एजुकेशनल इन्फॉर्मेशन। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस 130 इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम 1 to 130। सो गाइस, दोज हु आर न्यू ऑन आवर चैनल, प्लीज लाइक सब्सक्राइब एंड शेयर। दीज आर द इम्पॉर्टेंट, वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस एंड सेलेक्टेड क्वेश्चंस ओनली। सो गो वन बाय वन, डोंट मिस एनी वन क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम स्टार्टिंग टू एंडिंग। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विदाउट एनी डिले। सो नंबर ऑफ क्वेश्चन आर वेरी, सो दीज टॉपिक्स आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर योर अपकमिंग बीपीएससी, ऑल एग्जाम बीपीएससी एंड यूपीएससी, एसएससी, सीजीएल, बैंकिंग एंड ऑल स्टेट, अदर स्टेट लेवल पीएससी एग्जाम। सो वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन, प्लीज नोट डाउन इन टू योर कॉपी। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज, ईज ऑफ डूइंग बिजनेस इंडेक्स इज प्रिपेयर्ड एंड पब्लिश्ड बाय विच ऑर्गेनाइजेशन। द क्वेश्चन आई आस्क, ईज ऑफ डूइंग बिजनेस इंडेक्स इज प्रिपेयर्ड एंड पब्लिश्ड बाय हुज ऑर्गेनाइजेशन। करेक्ट ऑप्शन इज ऑप्शन बी, वर्ल्ड बैंक। द वर्ल्ड बैंक प्रिपेयर्ड एंड पब्लिश्ड बिजनेस इंडेक्स। सो इंडियाज रैंक इज 63rd इन 2020। देर आर 6 मेन फैक्टर्स इन कैलकुलेशन ऑफ रैंक। फर्स्ट वन इज लोकल गवर्नमेंट पॉलिसी, सेकेंड वन इज स्टेबल पावर सप्लाई, थर्ड वन इज अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ रॉ मटेरियल्स फॉर इंडस्ट्रीज, एंड फोर्थ वन इज पॉलिटिकल स्टेबिलिटी ऑफ कंट्री, फिफ्थ वन इज अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ ट्रेंड लेबर, एंड सिक्स वन इज अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ लैंड स्पेस फॉर बिजनेस। सो दीज आर द 6 पॉइंट्स। According to the 6 points, the business index has been prepared and published by the World Bank. So, ease of doing business index is prepared and published by World Bank. Next question is, which Indian state has highest number of cotton textile mills? So, correct option is option E, Tamil Nadu. In Tamil Nadu, there are highest number of cotton textile mills. So Tamil Nadu has more than 750 million cotton mills, followed by Maharashtra and then Andhra Pradesh. So correct option is option E, Tamil Nadu. Tamil Nadu has the highest number of cotton textile mills. Next question is, Black Revolution is related to which thing? Black Revolution. So Black Revolution means crude oil production. So here we will see, brown revolution is related to leather, green revolution is related with agriculture production, golden revolution is related with horticulture and honey and fruit production. So black revolution is related to crude oil production. Black Revolution. Next question is, first university started in which state to serve textile industry of country? First university. The question I asked, first university started in which state to serve textile industry of country? So correct option is option C, Gujarat. Gujarat government has started to serve textile industry of our country in India. So university is located at Surat. 90% of India's polyester comes from Surat city alone. So in 100%, 90% of India's polyester comes from Surat. Next question is, at which of the following places the copper industry is located? So correct option is option D, Khetri. Where is Khetri? Khetri is in Rajasthan. So Khetri is located in Jhunjhunu district of Rajasthan. So in Khetri, the copper industry is located. Next question is, which of the following iron ore is mined at Bailadila mines? Bailadila mines. So in Balaidela mines, hematite type of ore, iron ore is found out. So Balaidela mine is located in Dantewara district. It comes into the Deccan Plateau. So where is Dantewara district? In Chhattisgarh. So correct option is option A, hematite. Next question is, the only state which produces saffron in India is? So you already know, the saffron has been found in Jammu Kashmir in a very heavy atom. So in Jammu and Kashmir, Pampore is the most famous place for saffron production. So where is Pampore? In Jammu Kashmir. So in Jammu Kashmir, Pampore is the most famous place for saffron production. Next question is, Tata Nagar steel plant's water supply is done through which river? The supply of Tata Nagar steel plant from which river? So correct option is option A, Swarnarekha River. Swarnarekha and Kharkai rivers are water source for Jamshedpur city and steel plant. So correct option is option A, Swarnarekha Nadi. Next question is, which of the following is a silk textile production place in Bihar? In Bihar, where the following silk textile production? Correct option is option C, Bhagalpur. Bhagalpur is famous for the silk textile production. So Bhagalpur is also known as the capital of East Bihar. Next question is, Bharat Vegan and Engineering Corporation Limited is located at which place in Bihar? So correct option is option D, Mokama. Option D, Mokama. So where is Mokama? Mokama is located in Patna district. Mokama is located in Patna district, 90 km east of Patna city. From the Patna city, it is 90 km far away. So correct option is option D, Mokama. Next question is, which one of the following written industrial economy corridor of India? Industrial economy corridors of India is being developed with assistance of Japan. So correct option is option C, Delhi Mumbai. Delhi Mumbai written industrial economic corridor of India is being developed with assistance of Japan. So next question is, what is full form of EPCG? What is the full form of EPCG? So what is full form of EPCG? Export Promotions Capitals Goods. So Export Promotion Capital Goods, EPCG, as clear by name, it is related with capital goods for production. So correct option is option C, Export Promotions Capital Goods. You can say in short EPCG. Next question is, India's total share in meat exports in the world is? So question has been asked, India's total share in meat export in the world is? So 5%, 6%, 2%, 3%. So India is not supplier of the meat production among this percentage. So correct option is option E, none of this. So why none of this? Brazil is on top among meat exporters and India stands at number 2. India's shares changes every year from 15% to 20%. But here, in the range of 15% to 20%, there is no any percentage range meets here. So our correct option is option E, none of these. Now next question is, telecommunication comes in which type of industry category? This is a very important question, note down. सो करेक्ट ऑप्शन इज टेलीकम्युनिकेशन कम्स इन विच टाइप ऑफ इंडस्ट्री कैटेगरी. सो फर्स्ट प्राइमरी, सेकेंडरी, टर्सरी. सो टेलीकम्युनिकेशन सेक्टर डोंट कम इनटू द प्राइमरी सेक्टर एंड नॉट कम इनटू द सेकेंडरी सेक्टर ऑल्सो इवन इफ नॉट कम्स इनटू द टर्सरी सेक्टर. सो दीज ऑप्शन आर नॉन ऑफ दीज. वाई नॉन ऑफ दीज? ऑल टाइप ऑफ सर्विसेज कम्स अंडर टर्सरी सेक्टर ऑफ इंडस्ट्रीज. ऑल टाइप ऑफ सर्विसेज कम इनटू अंडर टर्सरी सेक्टर ऑफ इंडस्ट्रीज. सो हियर नन ऑफ दीज इज द करेक्ट आंसर. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज विच सिटी इज इन इंडिया ऑल्सो नोन एज सिल्क कैपिटल ऑफ इंडिया. सो यू ऑलरेडी नो बेंगलुरु इज कॉल्ड सिल्क कैपिटल ऑफ कंट्री. सो बेंगलोर इज ऑल्सो नोन एज सिल्क कैपिटल ऑफ इंडिया. कर्नाटका स्टैंड्स एट नंबर वन फॉर सिल्क प्रोडक्शन इन कंट्री. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज इन विच वन ऑफ द फॉलोइंग मिनरल्स इंडियाज रैंक नंबर वन इन द वर्ल्ड. सो इन विच मिनरल्स? ऑप्शन ए सीट मीका. सो वाई सीट मीका? इंडिया इज द लार्जेस्ट प्रोड्यूसर ऑफ सीट मीका इन द वर्ल्ड. इंडियाज रैंक एट फोर्थ फॉर आयरन ओर, अल्यूमिनियम, क्रोमाइट एंड बॉक्साइट. सो इन द वर्ल्ड इंडियाज फर्स्ट रैंक इन सीट मीका. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज विच स्टेट ऑफ इंडिया इज पॉपुलरली नॉन एज सुगर बॉल ऑफ द कंट्री. सो यू ऑलरेडी नो उत्तर प्रदेश. वाई उत्तर प्रदेश? नियरली 10% ऑफ टोटल सुगर कम्स फ्रॉम यूपी. वेस्टर्न यूपी इज नॉन फॉर सुगर मिल्स. सो डैट्स वाई उत्तर प्रदेश इज पॉपुलरली नॉन एज सुगर बॉल ऑफ द कंट्री. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज वट इज रैंक ऑफ बिहार स्टेट इन टर्म्स ऑफ टोटल जूट प्रोडक्शन अमॉन्ग स्टेट्स ऑफ द कंट्री. सो करेक्ट ऑप्शन इज ऑप्शन बी सेकेंड. सो इन जूट प्रोडक्शन फर्स्ट रैंक इज वेस्ट बंगाल. फर्स्ट वन इज वेस्ट बंगाल एंड देन सेकेंड इज बिहार. सो वेस्ट बंगाल स्टैंड्स एट नंबर वन वाइल बिहार एट नंबर टू. इन बिहार सीमांचल रीजन प्रोड्यूसेस जूट मेनली पूर्णिया एंड कटिहार डिस्ट्रिक्ट. सो करेक्ट ऑप्शन इज ऑप्शन बी इन द जूट प्रोडक्शन बिहार इज इन द सेकेंड रैंक. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन विच टाइप ऑफ इंडस्ट्रीज कैन सक्सीड इन बिहार. सो करेक्ट ऑप्शन इज ऑप्शन डी एग्रो बेस्ड इंडस्ट्री. इन एग्रो बेस्ड इंडस्ट्री सक्सीड इन बिहार. सो बिहार इज प्राइमरीली एग्रीकल्चरल बेस्ड स्टेट. इन इंडियाज स्टेट्स जीडीपी शेयर ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर इज नियरली 20%. सो करेक्ट ऑप्शन इज ऑप्शन डी एग्रो बेस्ड इंडस्ट्री. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज विच सेक्टर अट्रैक्ट्स मैक्सिमम फॉरेन डायरेक्ट इन्वेस्टमेंट इन इंडिया. सो करेक्ट ऑप्शन इज ऑप्शन ए सर्विसेज. इंडियाज अट्रैक्ट्स मैक्सिमम FDI इन सर्विसेज सेक्टर. एज पर लास्ट ईयर डाटा सिंगापुर इज द लार्जेस्ट इन्वेस्टर इन इंडिया. सो सर्विसेज सेक्टर्स अट्रैक्ट्स मैक्सिमम फॉरेन डायरेक्ट इन्वेस्टमेंट FDI इन इंडिया. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज डिफरेंस बिटवीन क्लोजिंग स्टॉक एंड ओपनिंग स्टॉक. क्लोजिंग स्टॉक एंड ओपनिंग स्टॉक ऑफ द ईयर इज पॉपुलरली नॉन एज. सो करेक्ट ऑप्शन इज ऑप्शन ए फिक्स्ड इन्वेस्टमेंट. व्हाई फिक्स्ड इन्वेस्टमेंट? अनसोल्ड गुड्स ऑफ एनी कंपनी इन द स्टार्ट ऑफ द अकाउंटिंग पीरियड इज नॉन एज ओपनिंग स्टॉक व्हाइल द अनसोल्ड गुड्स एट द एंड ऑफ द अकाउंटिंग पीरियड इज नोन एज द क्लोजिंग स्टॉक. सो डिफरेंस बिटवीन क्लोजिंग एंड ओपनिंग स्टॉक ऑफ द ईयर इज प्रॉपरली नॉन एज द फिक्स इन्वेस्टमेंट. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज वाट इज मीनिंग ऑफ नेशनल इनकम फॉर एनी कंट्री. क्वेश्चन इज आज वट इज मीनिंग ऑफ नेशनल इनकम फॉर एनी कंट्री. सो करेक्ट ऑप्शन इज ऑप्शन ए टोटल वैल्यू ऑफ गुड्स एंड सर्विस प्रोड्यूस्ड इन ए ईयर. टोटल वैल्यू ऑफ गुड्स एंड सर्विस प्रोड्यूस्ड इन ए ईयर. सो नेशनल इनकम स्टैंड्स फॉर वैल्यू ऑफ ऑल गुड्स एंड सर्विसेज प्रोड्यूस्ड इन द कंट्री. सो करेक्ट ऑप्शन इज ऑप्शन ए. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज डिफरेंस बिटवीन जीएनपी एंड एनएनपी इज इक्वल टू. डिफरेंस बिटवीन जीएनपी एंड एनएनपी इज इक्वल टू. सो जीएनपी इक्वल टू व्हाट? जीडीपी प्लस वेरियस इनकम्स फ्रॉम अब्रॉड. सो द करेक्ट ऑप्शन इज ऑप्शन डी कैपिटल डिप्रिसिएशन. कैपिटल डिप्रिसिएशन. सो डिफरेंस बिटवीन जीएनपी एंड एमएनपी इज इक्वल टू कैपिटल डिप्रिसिएशन. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज सो व्हाट इज एनएनपी? What is the full form of NNP? NNP stands for Net National Product. It is the sum total of goods and services produced in the country, leaving depreciation behind. So what is depreciation? Depreciation in economy stands for decrease in market value of any assets with time from various influential economic factors. So next question is appropriate example of capital intensive industry in country is. Appropriate example of capital intensive industry in country is. Correct option is option B steel industry. Why steel industry? So capital intensive industries are those that need high investment for production of goods. On the other hand, there are labor intensive industries too. So that's why the steel industry are the appropriate example of capital intensive industry. Next question is which among the following mentioned is not direct tax? Not direct tax. Why? We have already discussed of this question in previous videos. When you watch the GDP topics, we have already discussed. So sale is not the direct taxes. Why not direct taxes? Because the sale has been distributed into the two parts, state and central. So it is already divided into two. So it is not direct taxes. So direct tax is paid by individual or company directly to the government. So that's why sales is not direct tax. Next question is economic growth of any country is dependent on. So correct option is option C investment in the country. Economic growth of any country is dependent on the investment in country. So how many investment in your country, that is the base of the economic growth of any country. So economic growth is actually dependent on all factors that are mentioned above, but investment is the main factor. So how much invest in your country, how much invest in the industry, so this is the main factor. So that's why if in the economic growth of any country, the investment in the country is the main factor. Next question is gross profit means. What is gross profit means? So correct option is option D. Why D? Total receipt of a total expenditure of company or individuals, that is the gross profit. That is the gross profit. So D is the correct option. Next question is when surge in income, then how ratio between income and expenditure changes? Question as when surge in income, then how ratio between income and expenditure changes? So correct option is option B, ratio less than 1. Ratio less than 1. When ratio less than 1, the income and expenditure changes. Next question. Closed economy stands for. Closed economy stands for. So closed economy here, economy that does not trade with others. So what is it, closed economy? Economy that does not trade with others, that is called the economy. It's closed economy. So correct option is option A. Next question is what is meaning of मिक्स्ड इकोनॉमी. व्हाट इज मीनिंग ऑफ मिक्स्ड इकोनॉमी? सो को एग्जिस्टेंस ऑफ प्राइवेट एंड पब्लिक सेक्टर्स कंपनीज, को एग्जिस्टेंस ऑफ प्राइवेट एंड पब्लिक सेक्टर कंपनीज, दैट इज कॉल्ड द मिक्स इकोनॉमी. व्हाई मिक्स्ड इकोनॉमी? द मिक्स, व्हाट इज द मिक्स? प्राइवेट एंड पब्लिक सेक्टर कंपनीज, व्हेन बोथ द को एग्जिस्टिंग ऑफ प्राइवेट एंड पब्लिक सेक्टर कंपनीज मिक्स, दैट इज कॉल्ड द मिक्स इकोनॉमी. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, which of the following mentioned is actually a part of tertiary sector. So correct option is option A, transportation. Transportation is the main actual part of the tertiary sector. So everything that comes in services is a tertiary sectors. In services parts, we have already discussed in previous question, it is the transportation is actual part of a tertiary sector. Next question, when there will be exploitation of labor? So when exploitation of labor will happen, then what will happen? So wages of labor is less than marginal revenue product. So how when the wages of labor is less, the marginal revenue product is already less. So that's why exploitation of labor will happen. So option B is the correct option. Next question is, capital formation of any economy mainly depends on option C, total saving. Capital formation of any economy mainly depends on total saving. So how much total saving have you earned? So that thing will be dependent on the capital formation of any economic sector. So saving depends on the main factor, that is the main factor of capital formation of any economy. So option C is the correct option. Next question, an economy can be considered in state of equilibrium when total saving. The economy can be considered in state of equilibrium, that is state of equilibrium, that is you in the stable state, you can in the stable state. So when you will be stable, the total saving will be inquired. So that's why it will be considered in state of equilibrium. Next question is, taxation is a tool in any economy for. Taxation is a tool in any economy for. So correct option is option B, fiscal policy. So why fiscal policy? Fiscal policy is related with government's collection of money, and later that money is used for various government plans and schemes. So that's why fiscal policy has a taxation tool in any economy. Next question, what is crony capitalization? So this is very important question. What is crony capitalization? So crony capitalization is a condition in which government gives advantage to some private companies, and in return they help to political party rather than the country. So that's why crony capitalization is important for the political parties as well as the governments. So option A is the correct option. Why? Mutual advantages relation between business leaders and government officials. So option A is the correct option. So this is very important question, please note down. Next question is, which part of the country is known as cradle of Indian banking? So correct option is option B, coastal Karnataka. Why coastal Karnataka? Canada Bank, Canara Bank, Karnataka Bank, Vijaya Bank, Corporation Bank, Syndicate Bank, Vyas Bank, State Bank of Mysore. State Bank of मैसूर। नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज बैंक चेक्स आर प्रोसेस्ड बाय यूज ऑफ, सो हाउ बैंक चेक आर प्रोसेस्ड बाय यूज ऑफ MICR। दिस इज ऑल्सो द वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन। सो वॉट इज MICR? मैग्नेटिक इंक कैरेक्टर रिकॉग्नाइजेशन। वॉट इज द फुल फॉर्म ऑफ MICR? मैग्नेटिक इंक कैरेक्टर रिकॉग्नाइजेशन। सो इन द प्रोसेसिंग ऑफ बैंक चेक्स MICR इज यूज। नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज हाउ मच इज शेयर ऑफ स्टेट गवर्नमेंट इन RRB? हाउ मच शेयर ऑफ स्टेट गवर्नमेंट इन RRB? सो करेक्ट ऑप्शन इज ऑप्शन ए 15%। सो 15% इन सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट, 50% इन स्टेट गवर्नमेंट, 15% एंड स्पॉन्सर्ड बैंक्स आर 35%। सो दिस इज द टोटल परसेंटेज एक्सपेंडिचर शेयर इन RRB। नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज सो दीज आर द शेयर। फर्स्ट वन इज दक्षिण बिहार ग्रामीण बैंक। द बैंक वॉज इनकॉर्पोरेटेड ऑन 1st July 2019 बाय एमलगेमेटिंग ऑफ टू RRBs, नेमली मध्य बिहार ग्रामीण बैंक एंड बिहार ग्रामीण बैंक। दक्षिण बिहार ग्रामीण बैंक इज स्पॉन्सर्ड बाय पंजाब नेशनल बैंक। द बैंक ऑपरेट्स इन 20 डिस्ट्रिक्ट ऑफ बिहार। विच आर द 20 डिस्ट्रिक्ट? बांका, बेगूसराय, भागलपुर एंड जमुई। एंड नेक्स्ट वन इज खगड़िया, लखीसराय, बक्सर, रोहतास, मुंगेर, शेखपुरा एंड समस्तीपुर। द बैंक हैज 10078 ब्रांचेस एज ऑन 1st January 2019। डॉक्टर शमसुल आरिफ जॉर्ड इन द करेंट चेयरमैन ऑफ दक्षिण बिहार ग्रामीण बैंक। सो उत्तर बिहार ग्रामीण बैंक, इट इज स्पॉन्सर्ड बाय सेंट्रल बैंक ऑफ इंडिया इन द स्टेट ऑफ बिहार एज ए सिंगल रीजनल रूरल बैंक। द बैंक इज हेडक्वार्टर्ड इन मुजफ्फरपुर। द उत्तर ग्रामीण रीजनल बैंक फंक्शंस थ्रू ए नेटवर्क ऑफ 1001 ब्रांचेज इन 18 डिस्ट्रिक्ट इन द स्टेट ऑफ बिहार। नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज द टर्म माइक्रो इकोनॉमिक्स एंड मैक्रो इकोनॉमिक्स वेयर गिवन बाय। सो करेक्ट ऑप्शन इज ऑप्शन सी रेगनर फिश। माइक्रो फाइनेंस एग्जिस्ट एट स्मॉल लेवल लाइक टू हेल्प पीपुल बिलो पॉवर्टी लाइन etc. ऑन अदर हैंड माइक्रो फाइनेंस स्टैंड फॉर चांसेस इन इकोनॉमी सो इट इज एट लार्ज स्केल। सो माइक्रो इकोनॉमिक्स टर्म्स वेयर गिवन बाय रेगनर फिश। ऑप्शन सी इज द करेक्ट ऑप्शन। नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज अमर्त्य सेन वॉज गिवेन द नोबेल प्राइज फॉर कंट्रीब्यूशन इन। सो इन द फील्ड ऑफ वेलफेयर इकोनॉमिक्स अमर्त्य सेन वॉज गिवेन द नोबेल प्राइज फॉर कंट्रीब्यूशन। नोबेल प्राइज 1998। करेंटली सर्विंग एट प्रोफेसर ऑफ इकोनॉमिक्स एट हार्वर्ड यूनिवर्सिटी। सो करेक्ट ऑप्शन इज ऑप्शन बी वेलफेयर इकोनॉमिक्स। नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज हु इज नोन एज द फादर ऑफ इकोनॉमिक्स। सो करेक्ट ऑप्शन इज ऑप्शन डी एडम स्मिथ। दिस इज इजी क्वेश्चन। एडम स्मिथ। स्मिथ इज नोन फॉर हिज बुक वेल्थ ऑफ नेशंस। ही हैड गिवन आइडिया ऑफ एन इनविजिबल हैंड इन इकोनॉमी। फ्री मार्केट रेगुलेट देमसेल्व्स विदाउट intervention of central bank or any regulatory agencies by means of competition, supply demand system and self interest. So this is why he said invisible hand. So what is free market? The free market is an economic system where government has less or no control on the market. Next question is the price mechanism system is a feature of price mechanism system of a is a feature of price mechanism system is a feature of. So correct option is option A capitalist economy. Why capitalist economy? So in economics price mechanism is the way in which the profit of goods or services affect supply demand system. So that's why capitalist economy is the price mechanism is a feature of capitalist economy. Next question, human development index was developed by, so who has developed the human development index? So correct option is option C, Mahbub ul Haq has developed human development index. Next question is, if a country produces only consumer goods and nothing else, then what will happen? It is also the important question, note down. So if a country produces only consumer goods and nothing else, then what will happen? The country can become poor if external trade does not take place. So the country will become poor if external trade does not come. So why? Consumer goods are those products bought for consumption by consumer. Example, eatable capital goods, goods that are used in producing other goods. So that's why option C is the correct option. Next question is, what is hot money? So hot money is money that flows from the country to another to earn. That is called the hot money. Next question is, cheap money means, what is cheap money? Low rates of interest is called as cheap money. Next question is, minimum capital required for payment bank. So minimum capital required for payment bank is 100 crore. So this is the minimum capital requirement for payment banks. Next question is, according to socialism theory, who is the greatest enemy of society? So correct option is option A, personal property. Socialist ideology wants the entire production to control the property in state rather than any individual, so that more work can be done for collective social interest. So that's why socialism theory, according to the socialism theory, personal property is the greatest enemy of society. Next question is, how much FDI is allowed in defense sector? So this is very important question, note down. How much FDI is allowed in defense sector? So correct option is option B, 49. Option B is 49. 49 is allowed in the defense sector. 49%. FDI stands for foreign direct investment, which means investment by a person or company in some other country. So 49% FDI is allowed in defense sector. Next question is, which one is called core industry? So correct option is option A, basic industry is called as core industry. So why it is called basic industries? So core industries are those that serve to other industries. 8 industries in this list are coal, crude oil, natural gas, petroleum refinery industry, fertilizer, steel, cement and electricity. So these are the 8 industries in the list. Next question is, globalization of economy means, what is the meaning of globalization of economy? So integration of domestic economy with world economy. Integration of domestic economy plus world economy. So bankruptcy of Lehman Brothers Bank is an example because it has impacted entire world through it took place in USA. So that's why globalization takes stands. Next question is, hire and fire policy is related to which type of economy? So correct option is option A, capitalism. Why? कैपिटलिस्ट इकोनॉमी कंसिडर्स ऑल पॉसिबल वेज टू मेक प्रॉफिट हायर एंड फायर पॉलिसी इज रिलेटेड विथ कैपिटलिज्म. सो करेक्ट ऑप्शन इज ऑप्शन ए. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज व्हाट इज ट्रांसफर इनकम. सो व्हाट इज ट्रांसफर इनकम. सो करेक्ट ऑप्शन इज ऑप्शन ए. इनकम दैट डज नॉट कम फ्रॉम एनी टाइप ऑफ प्रोडक्शन. इनकम दैट डज नॉट कम फ्रॉम एनी टाइप ऑफ प्रोडक्शन इज कॉल्ड एज द ट्रांसफर इनकम. सो ऑप्शन ए इज द करेक्ट ऑप्शन. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज विच स्टेट इन इंडिया हैज हाइएस्ट जी डी पी एज पर कैपिटा. Which state in India has highest GDP per capita? So correct option is option B, Goa. Why Goa number one stands? Goa stands number one. Delhi at number two. While Bihar at bottom. Kerala stands number one in terms of HDI. HDI. Next question is. In which year 14 banks were nationalized in India? So correct option is option C. In 1969. 14 banks were nationalized in India. So 1969 and 1980 are 2 years when Indian banks got nationalized. 14 banks were nationalized in 1969 while 6 banks were nationalized in 1980. So total 14 banks were nationalized in India in the year 1969. Next question is, who used the Remedy Finance? Who used to Remedy Finance? So correct option is option C, RBI. RBI used the Remedy Finance. Next question is, which bank in India is known as lender of last resort? Lender of last resort. So correct option is option C, RBI. So why it is called lender of last resort? Lender of last resort means where there is no other option to lend from for any country, central bank is called lender of last resort. Next question is, cooperative banks have a structure of how many structure? 3-tier structure. So why 3-tier structure? The first tier is state level. Second one is district level. And third one is local level. So this is tier 1. This is tier 2. And this is tier 3. So why it is called tier 3? Because in both the 3 levels, cooperative banks are available. So that's why it is called the 3-tier structure. Next question is, what is definition of supply of goods? What is definition of supply of goods? So correct option is option D. Quantity of any good offered for sale at a fixed price per unit of time. So this is called supply of goods. So option D is the correct option. Next question. What is BMP in economics? What is BMP? BMP stands for value of marginal products. Value of marginal products. BMP stands for value of marginal products. It is related with revenue that comes from any particular productive output. It comes from any particular productive output. Next question. What is meaning of demand of any commodity? Demand of any commodity. So correct option is option C. Quantity of any commodity demanded at a certain price during particular time period. So why? Because in demand of commodity along with quantity, price and time period of demand are also important. So that's why the meaning of demand of any commodity means quantity of any commodity demanded at a certain price during particular time period. If the normal time, it is not demanded in the market. So that's why it is called demand of any commodity. Next question is, what was the objective of 5-year plan in India? What are the objectives? So first, economic growth, yes. Social justice, yes. थर्ड वन इज सर्च इन एम्प्लॉयमेंट अपॉर्चुनिटी, यस इट इज ऑल्सो. एंड फोर्थ वन इज ऑल ऑफ अबव, सो वी विल गो इन द फोर्थ वन, ऑल ऑफ द अबव, बिकॉज ऑल द ऑप्शंस आर प्रेजेंट, ऑल द ऑप्शंस फुलफिल द फाइव ईयर प्लान्स. सो फाइव ईयर प्लान्स हैड मल्टीपल ऑब्जेक्टिव्स. इवेंचुअली इट वॉज इंटेंडेड फॉर इकोनॉमिक ग्रोथ एंड सोशल जस्टिस. फर्स्ट प्लान स्टार्टेड इन ईयर 1951 एंड एंडेड इन 1956. फाइव ईयर प्लान सिस्टम एबोलिश्ड बाय गवर्नमेंट इन 2017. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज हाउ पॉवर्टी लाइन सिस्टम इज डिक्लेयर्ड इन इंडिया. हाउ पॉवर्टी लाइन सिस्टम इज डिक्लेयर्ड इन इंडिया. सो फर्स्ट ऑप्शन इज गवर्नमेंट कंडक्ट सर्वे एवरी फाइव ईयर्स इन द कंट्री, यस यस. एंड सेकेंड वन इज नेशनल सैंपल सर्वे ऑफिस इन द इज द एजेंसी टू कंडक्ट प्रोसेस, यस बोथ द ऑप्शन आर करेक्ट. सो ऑप्शन सी इज द करेक्ट ऑप्शन. एन एस एस ओ और नेशनल सैंपल सर्वे ऑफिस वॉज इस्टेब्लिश्ड इन ईयर 1950. इट हेड ऑफिस इज लोकेटेड इन न्यू दिल्ली. सो इट वर्क्स एज द सर्वे ऑफ द सर्वे एजेंसी टू कंडक्ट प्रोसेस. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज विच टाइप ऑफ बैंक्स हैव गिवन मैक्सिमम क्रेडिट टू एग्रीकल्चरल सेक्टर. विच टाइप ऑफ बैंक्स हैव गिवन मैक्सिमम क्रेडिट टू एग्रीकल्चरल सेक्टर. सो करेक्ट ऑप्शन इज ऑप्शन ए कमर्शियल बैंक्स. सो नंबर ऑफ ब्रांचेस एंड एबिलिटी टू गिव लोन आर इन फेवर ऑफ कमर्शियल बैंक्स. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज व्हाट इज फंक्शन ऑफ एसईबीआई. एसईबीआई व्हाट इज द फुल फॉर्म ऑफ एसईबीआई. एसईबीआई स्टैंड्स फॉर सिक्योरिटीज एंड एक्सचेंज बोर्ड ऑफ इंडिया. हेडक्वार्टर इज मुंबई एंड करेंट चेयरमैन इज अजय त्यागी. सो व्हाट इज द फंक्शन ऑफ एसईबीआई. टू रेगुलेट सिक्योरिटी एंड कमोडिटी मार्केट. टू रेगुलेट सिक्योरिटी एंड कमोडिटी मार्केट. सो दिस इज द फंक्शन ऑफ एसईबीआई. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज व्हाट इज मीनिंग ऑफ प्राइस फ्लोरिंग इन इकोनॉमी. प्राइस फ्लोरिंग इन इकोनॉमी. सो करेक्ट ऑप्शन इज ऑप्शन बी सरप्लसेस ऑफ एनी गुड. सरप्लसेस ऑफ एनी गुड. सो ऑप्शन बी इज द करेक्ट ऑप्शन. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज व्हाट इज द मेन इकोनॉमिक प्रॉब्लम ऑफ इंडियन सोसाइटी. व्हाट इज द मेन इकोनॉमिक प्रॉब्लम ऑफ इंडियन सोसाइटी. सो करेक्ट ऑप्शन इज ऑप्शन डी स्कार्सिटी. सो स्कार्सिटी इज द बिग प्रॉब्लम ऑफ इंडियन सोसाइटी. इफ एनीथिंग हैज बीन द स्कार्सिटी ऑफ दैट प्रोडक्ट देन द इकोनॉमिक प्रॉब्लम विल बी हैपन. सो दैट इज द मेन फैक्टर. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज व्हाट इज प्योर मार्केट इकोनॉमी. सो व्हाट इज प्योर मार्केट इकोनॉमी. मार्केट इटसेल्फ कंट्रोल ऑल एस्पेक्ट. इन प्योर मार्केट सिस्टम गवर्नमेंट विल नॉट कंट्रोलिंग एनीथिंग. सो दैट्स व्हाई इट इज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ द प्योर मार्केट इकोनॉमी. सो ऑप्शन ए इज द करेक्ट ऑप्शन. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज व्हाट इज लॉ ऑफ डिमांड इन इकोनॉमी. सो लॉ ऑफ डिमांड इन इकोनॉमी. एज प्राइसेस गो हाई quantity demanded falls. So this is the law of the economy. Next question is which are the four factors of production. First one is land, second one is labor, third one is capital, and fourth one is enterprise. So correct option is option A. So these are the four factors of the production. Next question is What is meaning of great depression in economics? So correct option is option D, fall of economy from 1929 to 1939. Fall of economy from 1929 to 1939 has a great depression in economics. In the history of industrialized world period 1929 to 1939 is considered as great depressions because of stock market crash in USA. So that's why it is called the Great Depression in economics from the year 1929 to 1939. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज विच कंट्रीज टुक मैक्सिमम एडवांटेज ऑफ ग्लोबलाइजेशन ऑफ इकोनॉमी. सो करेक्ट ऑप्शन इज ऑप्शन डी. व्हाई नन? बिकॉज पुअर कंट्रीज, डेवलप्ड कंट्रीज एंड डेवलपिंग कंट्रीज. सो दिस नॉट बिकॉज पुअर कंट्रीज डिड नॉट टुक मैक्सिमम एडवांटेज ऑफ ग्लोबलाइजेशन इकोनॉमी. डेवलप्ड कंट्री इट ऑल्सो डज नॉट टेक एडवांटेज. So developing countries, it also does not take advantage of globalization of economy. So that's why no any options has been come in this question. So correct option is option D, none. Definitely, developed countries took maximum advantage as they started targeting global market. India has huge population and numerous countries see India as one of their potential market where they can sell. So that's why potential market. Where they can sell. Next question is, two important factors of globalization of economy are, first one is liberalization and second one is privatization. So liberalization comes from when government relaxes various rules for investment or when private companies enter economy. So two factors are liberalization and second one is privatization. Next question is, opportunity cost theory was given by, first correct option is option A, Gottfried Heavier gives the opportunity cost theory. Next question is, what is meaning of monopoly in economics? So correct option is option A, market in control of a single seller for particular products. So monopoly matlab means market in control of single seller control all the market in the particular product. So the biggest disadvantage of monopoly is single seller control price. Why? If the single seller fix the price, the market have to purchase in that cost. So that's why this is the disadvantage. Next question is, what affects purchasing power of any currency? What affects purchasing power of any currency? So first one is unemployment in the country, second one is average salary of the country, third one is employment level. So these are the affects purchasing power of any currency. So correct option is option D, all of these. So purchasing power depends on various factors and all above mentioned have role in purchasing power. Next question is, where is headquarter of Karnataka Bank? So correct option is option B, Mangalore. This bank started in year 1924. Current MD and CEO is Mr. Mahabaleshwar is the current MD and CEO of Karnataka Bank. Next question is, What is velocity of money? So correct option is option C, number of times money changes hand in a year. So number of times money changes hand in a year is the called of the velocity of money. Next question is, law of demand is based on which assumption? So correct option is option D, income of consumer will remain in fact. Income of consumer will remain in fact. So correct option is option D. Next question is, surge in the supply of commodity takes place when? First one is, there is improvement in a technology, yes. Fall in cost of other commodity, yes. Average salary goes high, yes. So option D is the correct option, because all three A, B and C are the fulfill the supply of commodity takes place when all three happened. So correct option is option D, all of the three above. Next question is, when price of any commodity goes below equilibrium, then when price of any commodity goes below equilibrium, then shortage of that commodity. So after the shortage of that commodity, it goes into the equilibrium state. Next question is, if there is impact on any country's economy because of import and export, then that of economy is called open economy. That economy type economy is called open economy. Next question is, agricultural and mining are examples of which industry? So correct option is option A, labor intensive industry. So agricultural and mining are based on labor efforts. On other hand, there are industries like iron, steel that are capital intensive industry. So correct option A is the correct option. What are objectives of IMF? So what is IMF? IMF stands for International Monetary Fund. So IMF stands for International Monetary Funds. So first point is for International Monetary Corporation. Yes. Second one is balanced economic growth. Third one is controlling in the equilibrium in the trade. Third one is handling depreciation because of competition. So all the four options fulfill. So correct option is option D, all of the above. IMF stands for International Monetary Fund, established in the year 1945. Headquarter at Washington DC and current chief economist is Geeta Gopinath. Geeta Gopinath is the current chief economist. Next question is, production of commodity that comes from natural resources is considered in which sector? Production of commodity that comes from natural resources is considered in which sector? So correct option is option A, primary sector. Option A is the primary sector. Agricultural and mining are two prominent names in primary sector. Production in other sectors depend on primary. Next question is, relation between consumption level and rate of interest was first given by? Correct option is option B, Milton Friedman. So Milton was an American economist who was given Nobel Prize in 1976 for this theory. Next question is, who gave population theory of economics? Population theory of economics. So correct option is option A, Robert Malthus gave the population theory of economics. Next question is, economics comes under which category? So correct option is option B, social science. Economics come into the social science. Next question is, availability of labor in any economy mainly depends on? Availability of labor in any economy mainly depends on population of that region. Yes, population of that region. India is among countries where cheap labor is easily available. Next question is, consumption function for any economic arrangement gives relation between consumption and income. Why? Income and consumption are directly proportional to each other. Income is directly proportional to the consumption. As income goes high, there is parallel consumption to surges. So that's why consumption function of any economic arrangement gives the relation between consumption and income. Next question is, price theory shows relation between supply and demand. Price theory is about supply and demand in any economy. So correct option is option C, supply and demand. Price theory shows the relation between supply and demand. Next question is, who had said that investment is the construction of new capital? Who had said that investment is the construction of new capital. So correct option is option B, Keynes. Keynes is better known for his theory of employment and wages in the economics. Next question is, Indian economy is which type of economy? Is a labor surplus economy. Indian economy is the labor surplus economy. So by 2030, India is supposed to have 245 million skilled labor unemployment. Next question is, capital formation in any economy depends mainly upon saving of country. So how much the saving has been comes in the country, that is depend on the capital formation. Next question is, when equilibrium changes between supply and demand, so what happened? Internal factor affects its equilibrium condition. So internal factor affects equilibrium condition. So government policies can also bring in change for equilibrium condition, but that would not be that effective as various internal factors. Next question is, what is marginal revenue? What is marginal revenue? So correct option is option B, revenue that comes when an additional sales unit is established. So that is called as marginal revenue. Revenue that comes when an additional sales unit is established. Next question is, in any economy, factors that determine social infrastructure are, option B is the correct option, education, health and civil amenities. So social infra is supposed to be the base of economy. In any developed economy, one can find well built social infra. So correct option is option B, education, health and civil amenities. Next question is, what is meaning of distinct unemployment? Disguised employment. So correct option is option C, more people engaged in any work than required. More people engaged in any work than required. That is, number of peoples are more, but the work requirement is less. So visibly employed, but actually they are not employed. This is disguised unemployment. Next question is, disinvestment is also popularly known as, disinvestment is also popularly known as privatization. In last few years, Government of India did disinvestment in 23 government companies, namely BEML, Air India, BPCL, etc. Next question is, economy of development depends on which factors? Economic development depends on which factor? So correct option is option D, all of them. What are the points? Availability of natural resources, availability of capital for business, size of economy. So all three points are the factors that economic development depends. So option D is the correct option. So there are more than 10 factors on which economic development of any state depends. Next question is, expenditure that any company does on promotion and advertisement considered as. So correct option is option C, intermediate consumption. Intermediate consumption. So option C is the correct option. Next question is, India's first national income committee was set up in the year 1949. First chairman of National Income Committee was Mahala Nobis, and according to the report given in 1954, India's income was 8,710 crore. So next question is, why India's exports surged in last few decades? First one is because of liberalization of economy. Yes, रिडक्शन इन वेरियस टैक्सेस, यस. डाइवर्सिफिकेशन ऑफ एक्सपोर्ट्स, यस. सो ऑल ऑफ द अबव आर द पॉइंट्स दैट एक्सपोर्ट्स सर्ज इन लास्ट फ्यू ईयर डिकेड्स. सो ऑप्शन डी इज द करेक्ट ऑप्शन. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज सर्ज इन पर कैपिटा इनकम फॉर एनी कंट्री इज कंसिडर्ड पॉजिटिव व्हेन. सर्ज इन पर कैपिटा इनकम फॉर एनी कंट्री इज कंसिडर्ड पॉजिटिव व्हेन डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन गोइंग इन फेवर ऑफ पुअर. डेफिनेटली इनकम डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन विल बी नॉट कंसिडर्ड इवन अंटिल इज डज नॉट शिफ्ट टूवर्ड्स पुअर. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज विच वन कंट्रीब्यूट्स टू जीडीपी एट फैक्टर कॉस्ट. विच वन कंट्रीब्यूट्स टू जीडीपी एट फैक्टर कॉस्ट. सो करेक्ट ऑप्शन इज ऑप्शन सी रेंट. जीडीपी एट मार्केट प्राइस मीन्स सम ऑफ ऑल द प्रोडक्ट्स एंड सर्विसेज. ऑन अदर हैंड जीडीपी एट फैक्टर कॉस्ट मीन्स इनकम लाइक रेंट इंटरेस्ट इटीसी. सो करेक्ट ऑप्शन इज ऑप्शन सी रेंट. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज हु एस्टिमेटेड नेशनल इनकम फर्स्ट टाइम इन इंडिया. सो करेक्ट ऑप्शन इज ऑप्शन ए दादाभाई नेहरूजी. ऑप्शन ए दादाभाई नेहरूजी. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज what will be GDP at factor cost. So correct option is option A GDP plus subsidy is equal to indirect taxes. So when you combine GDP plus subsidies is equal to indirect taxes. Next question is VKRB Rao is known for his contribution in calculation of national income. Next question is biggest nationalized enterprise in India is Indian Railways. So why it is biggest nationalized enterprise? Because the turnover of Indian Railways is the more in the other enterprise. Next question is in India organized sector data is collected by which agency? Correct option is option A NSSO. Next question is what will not happen when interest will go up in any economy? So correct option is option D return on capital increases. When return on capital increases the interest will go up in any economy. Next question is who is chairman of finance commission in year 2020? Chairman of finance commission in year 2020. So correct option is N.K. Singh is the chairman of finance commission in year 2020. Next question is Gadgil formula was used for. So Gadgil formula used for distribution of tax among states. So Gadgil formula is used for distribution of tax among states. Next question is which commission distributes central government tax collection among states. So correct option is option A finance commission. Option A is the finance commission. Finance commission distributes central government tax collection among states. Next question, what is dumping in economics? So dumping is used for international trade when export is done in a country where price of product is lower than producing country. So C is the correct option. Next question is tax is collected by government for fiscal policy decisions. So option B is the correct option. Next question is who is called architect of GST. So correct option is Vijay Kelkar is called architect of GST. Next question is what is tax buoyancy. So tax fluctuation rate when GDP goes up or down is called the tax buoyancy. So option B is the correct option. Next question is why parallel economy emerges in the country. So why parallel economy emerges in the country? Because of the tax evasion. So parallel economy can be termed as unsanctioned sector of economy. So this is also termed as black economy, and it bring loss in government's revenue. Next question is, which sector gives maximum tax to government of India? So correct option is option B, industrial sector. Industrial sector gives maximum tax to the government of India. Next question is, which of the following does not come in the category of national debt? Correct option is option C, insurance policy. Insurance policy does not come in the category of national debts. National saving certificate, government bonds, and PF of employees, these all three are the come in the category of the national debt. Next question is, which bank was earlier named as Imperial Bank of India? So correct option is option C, SBI. State Bank of India was earlier named as Imperial Bank of India. Next question is, why was SIDBI established? So SIDBI stands for Small Industries in 1990 and headquarters at Lucknow. Current chairman is Mohammad Mustafa. So why it is established? To assist small industries through finance. So that's why he was established. Next question is, when IDBI turned from public sector bank to a private sector bank? Correct option is option A, January 2019. Mr. M. R. Kumar is the current chairman. Bank was established by Government of India in 1964 and operated initially as subsidiary of RBI. Next question is, how many public sector banks left after recent merger? So correct option is option C, 12. 12 public sector banks left after recent merger. There were 27 PSUs banks in India in 2017. Now number has been reduced to 12 after merger. Next question is, which PSU bank has least government shareholdings? So correct option is option A, SBI. In SBI, government share is only 61% left. UCO Bank has 93% government share, which is maximum among all PSUs bank. Next question is, what is full form of NABARD? So NABARD full form is National Bank of Agricultural and Rural Development. So headquarter is at Mumbai, established in 1982, and current chairman is Harsh Kumar Barnwal. Next question is, what is excess reserve in economics? So correct option is option A, cash held by bank above minimum requirements to set by RBI. So excess reserve in economics means cash held by bank above minimum requirements set by RBI. Next question is, repo rate and CRR are tools of monetary policy by RBI. So these are the tools of repo rate and CRR are tools of monetary policy by Reserve Bank of India. RBI comes up with monetary policy in every 2 months. In every 2 months, RBI comes up with monetary policy in 2 months. So these are total 130 questions. These are very important questions for your BPSC project measure exam, BPSC CDPO exams, BPSC CSE, UPSC, SSC, CGL banking exams, and all state level PSC exams. So these are very, very important questions. Please note down into your copy, and I will give you the set of 500 economics questions in the description box. You can go in the description box and you can download इंपॉर्टेंट 500 क्वेश्चंस, इकोनॉमिक्स क्वेश्चंस फॉर योर अपकमिंग एग्जाम्स. सो आई वांट टू से थैंक्स ऑल ऑफ यू माय फ्रेंड्स. थैंक यू सो मच फॉर वाचिंग दिस वीडियो एंड आई होप दिस ऑल इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस विल बी हेल्पफुल फॉर योर एग्जामिनेशन. सो दोस who are new on our channel, please like, subscribe and share the content of your family, friends and your close one for important examination. So thank you for watching this video.